Thank you for joining us today at Miniature Wargaming Labs. Today, we'll be going into the Age of Sigmar Dominion box to build an orc model. And the one we're going to build today is the Gut Ripa boss. So, let's get our sprue out. You can tell this is sprue A. The little label's right there for the A. And let's go over our tools here. We're gonna use some clippers, nice and sharp. The flat back edge there. X-Acto blade, metal file. I like to use a set of tweezers on hand. Super glue, and plastic glue. And I will be assembling this in my baking sheet. There, you can see, and the reason is this slip right here prevents bits from hitting the plate and bouncing off. Like if you're doing a table, it's not fun to pick the bits out of the carpet. All right, now to get started, we're going to take our clippers here. Say clippers, just like an orc would. All right, so we're doing the boss. So we want A1, A2, and A4 to start off. These are the first ones I'm assembling here. Had it right in front of me. Well, it is in front of me. Gotta tilt it in the light to see the one I'm looking for. There it is. There's one. Okay. Trim it there. And we take the flat edge. And we hold the flat edge to the model. Snip those off. Then what I'm going to do is take this piece and lay it down where it's supposed to go. Man, in this sprue, they really scattered them around. They are all over the place. Okay, so we'll get A2 here, so a snip here. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hunt and peck to try to find all the little sprue pieces I need, lay them out there, and then we'll set them down, and then we'll begin assembling. Well, I found all the pieces finally, and we clipped those out. There's not many of them here, but what we're gonna do is take our X-Acto blade, and we are going to find all the little spots where the sprue tied into the model. We're going to trim those down just to make them smooth and flush. Because even though we try to get a tight cut against there, it doesn't always get there. And this helps with the fit of the model sometimes, but mostly helps with the paint job so these little pieces don't show up. Now something I like to do is go a step further. I like to smooth these down. That way when I run a wash over them, it won't catch. And I'm going to look for any mold lines. So there might be a little light line of plastic that connects all those little nubbins there. And what we're going to do is just smooth those off. And I'm going to go around and do all these little pieces here. And then we'll start assembly. Now we have all the models cleaned and assembled. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna start with one and two. One is this little piece right here on the arm. It's gonna go into the center hole of the rear torso. And you can use the shoulder, push that up until it hits the top there. That way you know where it goes. And then we're going to do a little dry fit here. We're just going to see a little bit of the placement. So you go like that, leaving that gap open. All right. Then I'm going to get my plastic glue. This won't set right away, but it'll start sticking right away, which gives you a chance to maneuver the piece around if you make a mistake. Or you got to jiggle some pieces into place. Now, need his cowl. Let's see, check that out. Okay, that cowl will have the neck piece. Cool. Then we'll slide some glue on the neck hole. Really don't want it going into the rod or the receiving port. There we go. Careful where you place your fingers. Feed some glue down into those. Make sure it holds really well. And we'll squeeze here. While I'm waiting for that, let's see. I want to put... All right, get some super glue. Trying to keep that face and back all pinched together. There we go. Now let's do the shield. Let's see. Goes like that. All right. Now to glue around the little knob. Not on it. Okay. Gonna turn it up like that. Okay, there we go. All right, there we go. That's our Gut Ripper boss. You can tell it because he has the fancier hat. Well, thank you for joining us at Miniature Wargaming Labs, and we'll see you next time.